Hi there, this is Josh. Please note that this SketchUp Skill Builder is in layout. I'd like to show a few different ways you can use clipping masks. You may be familiar with a clipping mask in other software, and here's how easy they are to use in layout. I can select a SketchUp viewport, hold down Shift, and select some layout line work that I've drawn, and then right-click on those entities and look for Create Clipping Mask. You'll notice the SketchUp viewport is trimmed away, and if I want to jump back in there and make some edits, I certainly can. Just double click and I'm entering this special clipping mask group, and I can easily reposition or resize and then click away when that's looking good, and you'll see the new positioning reflected there. I can grab the line tool. If I'm looking for a more irregular shape, just draw whatever shape you need. Any shape will do. Select that shape, select that viewport, right click, create clipping mask, boom. That easy. You could also go to, let's say, the freehand tool if you're looking for perhaps a more complex or a more irregular shape for that clipping mask, and do something like this, and then select those two things, make that clipping mask, and let's bring these together and take a look at styling. If you would like to add a little bit of styling to these clipping mask groups, all you have to do is cruise over to that shape style panel here, engage that stroke button, and let's throw a dashed line on this one. And perhaps you don't want to have any, actually need to make sure that this button here is turned on so that the stroke is engaged. And for this one, the actual boundary for this clipping mask is probably better left invisible. So in some cases you may not want to show any styling, or you don't want to see that boundary at all. And a common example of this is an architectural detail. So in this case I've got a SketchUp viewport here, and the same viewport here behind this clipping mask where it's just scaled up, and this might be a faster way to call out something that you're trying to show rather than maybe going back into SketchUp and creating a new scene or recomposing the view. Think about using layout for something like this sometimes, and then you can just jump back in to your layout tools and add whatever styling or annotations that you need, and then again go back over to the shape style panel here and you can add all kinds of different styling to those annotations. Another example of this is with an elevation. I'm going to go back to that line tool, and let's say I was tracing a grade line, or in this case I just kind of want to cut away part of this SketchUp view here that I don't want to see. So in this case I'm going to zoom in, and you'll notice that I can use all these snapping points that I have in my SketchUp model, cruise along the line here, and just trace what I need for this boundary, and zoom out a little bit, and I'll draw this over to the side and come back over the top of this viewport. And one way I could have done this, let's make this clipping mask real quick, I could have just drawn a shape that I then put on top of the SketchUp viewport, maybe color it white so it blends in with the page. That's certainly one way to go. The advantage of this method is I'm now able to click around down here and not, you know, click on any layout geometry that I've drawn. I just have that simple clipping mask, and this leaves this kind of free for easy annotations, dimensions, and notes and stuff like that. And finally, a really simple way to use a clipping mask is perhaps to just crop an image. So you could certainly crop an image in whatever image editing software you have, but hey, why not just do that in layout? Grab those two entities, make that clipping mask, and this little fella looks pretty excited about how easy it is to use clipping masks in layout. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.